Trauma experienced in childhood can have the lifelong effect of holding you back from living a life filled with love and can prevent you from having the love relationship of your dreams. Today's speaker will share with you her research and wisdom that she has honed into revealing the 10 traumas, how to recognize destructive patterns used by trauma survivors, and how to get free from the loop of continuing trauma. Welcome to the Women in Love Summit. Sigmund Freud asked this question many decades ago, and I'm asking it again. What do women want? I'm your host, Dr. Erica Goodstone. In this event, I'm speaking with leading authors, teachers, trainers, therapists, coaches, and healthcare professionals to discover what women want, need, desire, and what interferes with and what enhances their capacity to give and receive love. Rhianna Milne is a certified global relationship love and life coach, best-selling author, and life and dating coach for the new docuseries, Radical Dating, Finding Lasting Love Over 40. And she's doing so much more that she will share with us. So for me, it's an absolute pleasure to be speaking with you, Rhianna Milne.
Thank you, Erica. Thank you. Like I was saying, as we were chatting, we're very dedicated. We're right in the midst of a hurricane right now. So
well, it's imminent.
You know, we're here for you. So
it's imminent, and yet we're still meeting.
We're both in Florida and only about 20 minutes from each other. So, yeah, quite a day.
And we originally met at a SCORE meeting.
We did.
Retired professionals talking about building business, and you've certainly been building a lot. So I would love you to tell us how this all evolved. Like, where did you start from?
Sure.
Your training background, and what led you to write your book, and now you're going to have a school.
Okay. Yes. Well, my credentials are I'm a licensed mental health counselor, a certified clinical trauma professional, a certified addictions professional, a student assistance counselor, and I'm an educational motivational speaker and the best-selling author of two books, Live and Love Beyond Your Dreams. And for 18 years, I've had my practice Therapy by the Sea, 14 years in Atlantic City area of New Jersey, and since 2014, I've been in Delray Beach, Florida, but I'm global. So the majority of my coaching now is worldwide. The furthest client I've had so far is in Lebanon. And it's interesting working with those from the war zones, you know, who grew up with war around them, because there's all this, you know, inner anxiety and many childhood traumas that are impacting them as an adult in life and love. And in 2009 and 10, I went to RCI, Relationship Coaching Institute, and got certified as a life, love, dating, relationship coach for singles and couples. And my most recent project is a Life and Love Training Academy.com, where I'm offering my services as a coach online for groups, both for singles, that program's Dating to Mating, and for couples, which is called Relationship Rescue. And that is open right now in September. So I'm very excited about that. I'll be able to reach many more people. And we do a live coaching every week. So I can really help them one-on-one. And it's video coaching. So they can see me. And if they want to come on, I can see them. And it's a little bit more personal. So very excited about that starting up. Why I got involved with trauma? Well, basically, I had to find answers for myself. I was easily I could attract men to date. Actually, a friend asked me the other day, how many times was I asked to be married? 9 times. So I could do the attraction part. That was easy for me. I had those skills, but I was attracting the wrong person. I couldn't figure out why. And I had married someone that ended up being a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Dr. Jekyll's very well loved in the community, very outgoing, socially confident, attractive. He had a job as a principal in a school. Everyone loved him, the parents, the kids, everything else. And Mr. Hyde is a hidden personality type that, you know, was doing other things behind people's back, including mine. And when he was caught with porn on his computer at the school and having an affair with a teacher, I acted as my own attorney and went and annulled that marriage. And I was very proud of that because I was really in post-traumatic shock. So, you know, other women that might have gone through any traumatic experience by being deceived, lied to, And it was quite traumatizing. Thank God I had the resiliency factors that I also teach my people who are going through difficult transitions, how to stay tough and have a positive mindset still for success, handle what you have to handle, move forward, and don't stay stuck in self-pity or taking all this blame upon yourself. You know, if you know you're a good partner and they're the ones doing something out of integrity, then we just move forward. So I do help people with difficult transitions who are either recipients of some traumatic situation or have grown up with childhood trauma and now it's impacting them in either who they attract in love or what's coming out in their love relationships, and they don't know quite why, you know, this toxic stuff is coming out. And I did the research for me because I wanted to know what did he have. I have a triple master's in applied clinical counseling psychology, graduated with honors, summa cum laude, 4.0. And not once did I hear the term about childhood trauma. So I took it on myself. I did 2 years of research. That's why Love Beyond Your Dreams is, you know, one of the books I use for the program, Break Free of Toxic Relationships to Have the Love You Deserve. And it's that research plus my workbooks that I use in my programs, either VIP who works for one-on-one with me or in the school to get them the latest information about trauma response, why are we attracting what we're attracting? Because the breakup factors are ridiculous. Marriages are breaking up now at 60%, you know, and studies show, the latest studies, close to 90% of adults in America are affected by childhood trauma. So they have at least one of the 10 traumas, and it's coming out and playing havoc in our love relationship.
I'd like to just get back to something that you said, that you worked with someone from Lebanon, and I've seen many of these videos online showing the trauma. Mm-hmm. Someone dies in front of them, and they're running from being attacked or being sheltered and, you know, cornered and... There's such fear. And so you're reaching out to them. That's beautiful. And we need so much help right here.
We do.
Plenty of trauma, small and large, that people go through. So I have a question to ask. How does experiencing trauma in childhood or even later on hold one back from having a life filled with loving relationships?
Well, because they carry the trauma forward. What happened here comes out later as an adult. And maybe if I mention the 10 traumas and then answer that question, Erica, it'll make a little bit more sense, if I may. Okay, so the 10 traumas, and if you have a pen and paper, you might want to write them down because I'm very curious, you know, how many of the traumas you might have. Because most people say, well, I didn't have a traumatic childhood. It's pretty normal. But when you hear the 10, and this is only the most common 10, there's more than this. But I mentioned 10 in my speaking. So the first one is if you grew up with a parent with any addiction. So the typical ones are drug, alcohol, but then there's sex, porn, cheating, hoarding, spending, eating, TV addiction, gaming, you know, online gaming, anything where you felt ignored, where the addiction came first. Second, were you a recipient of or did you witness domestic violence? So that means any verbal abuse, emotional abuse or neglect, physical abuse, rape, or molestation, either in or outside of the home. Abandonment, and there's fault and no fault. And no fault abandonment is if a parent dies early or their parent has to leave the home all the time to work. Now, that was one for me. My dad was gone much of the time, but we didn't know at the time he was FBI, CIA. My dad was like James Bond. Okay, but we didn't know that. And but he was working, and that is a no-fault abandonment. A fault abandonment is like after a divorce, the parent promises to see you and drops the ball or doesn't see you as much as they say they would. The next one is if you were part of adoption, foster care, or had to live with other people because your parents couldn't take care of you. Personal trauma, that's a big one, and I fall under that category too, which was bullying. I was very skinny with big glasses when I was a kid and teased terribly for many, many years. So I was kind of quiet and shy as a kid. People know me, would like say, Brianna, that's impossible.
Right.
But I stayed it to myself until I got into modeling school. I won a scholarship through my writing, actually. And then my self-esteem went up with that. But So personal trauma could be being bullied, having a medical condition when you were young, just feeling different when you were young, like a lot of overweight kids. I had a beautiful African-American girl in my office. She goes, no, my family was great. I said, I got to that one. She goes, oh, wow, I was only the only black girl in an all-white school. I was teased horribly. I never felt like I fed in. I was always felt different. So that's a big one. The next one is sibling trauma. If your sibling developed an issue as a teen or was born with complications and they got more attention than you, or if they were the golden child of your parents and you were kind of just always compared to them and never felt good enough, or the sibling teased you. The next one is family trauma. This is a big one. This is very common. Now, here we are, all these people in Texas and people in Florida are leaving their homes. So one is loss of home by flood and fire, an incarceration in the family, moving a lot. If you're a military family, they move every 3 to 4 years. Growing up with poverty. Again, the most common since 2008, a lot is loss of home by flood, fire, mortgage crises, hurricanes. These are becoming more and more common. War experiences around the war zones. This is family trauma. And then the last one is mental health issues in your mom or dad. And the most common that are the most severe are bipolar, which we call manic depressive, and borderline personality types, which are more prevalent than people think. And then, of course, ongoing anxiety and depression. When these present, these cause the most havoc and tend to be passed down to the children. And the worst thing is childhood trauma goes through the generations. So unless you do some real work around this, it will keep going down to your children. So, you know, if your listeners are saying, wow, I did have some of these traumas, look at your mom or dad. Did your mom or dad come from trauma? What did they experience? And then you'll start seeing it through the generations. So my program does teach people how to either find love by attracting it to you or fix love if you're in a coupled relationship. But the first part of it is this life coaching to really acknowledge and analyze and understand what are the life traumas that they have experienced when they were very innocent and young. You know, couldn't help it. It just happened to us. And how is it playing out in their relationships? Which, Erica, gets back to your original question. Okay. That's why I said, let me tell you them first, because that'll be a little easier.
But listening to you, I would say most of us have had some of that trauma.
Yes.
You know, maybe minor degrees. Not everyone had a full-blown trauma.
Yes. And then there's a rating scale from 0 to 10. So something like a rape, of course, is a 10. You know, so it's severity levels we look at too. How many, what are the severity levels? And everybody that comes to me is a different puzzle. And I serve men, women, gay, straight, young, old, single, couple, it doesn't matter. The common element of who I work with is those with this trauma situation that is impacting their ability to find and keep love, healthy love, emotionally healthy, evolved and conscious love. That's what I teach. And because of the trauma, you know, they may have a negative mindset. They're more negative than positive. My clients come to me with ongoing anxiety, always feeling anxious or a bit panicked. Depression is very common in them as well. And I do holistic remedies. My people that have come to me on meds aren't on meds anymore. So I use vitamin therapy, meditation. I use a lot of techniques that I learned in trauma, you know, as a trauma professional. So, for example, let's get back to someone who is jealous, okay, probably did experience both bullying, not feeling good enough, and also abandonment issues. Those are the two common ones. Someone that's passive aggressive, meaning if they're upset, they shut down, they may punish you through quietness and not talk to you for a while, and then later lash out at you about something that shouldn't have been a big deal. This is someone that learned to be quiet around a mad mom or dad, because if they spoke up, they would have been severely punished. You know, so that's someone that gets so scared, they shut down, and it's hard for them to feel safe enough to talk. So I talk, you know, teach communication skills for these couples that are in these bad, conflicted, traumatic, and toxic relationships. Another one would be, controlling your partner. Same thing, that's someone that had no control as a child or acting out controlling you because they don't have any personal control in their own life. That's common. Being a people pleaser. Okay, this tends to happen mostly with women. So, you know, they would learn to charm or manipulate or people please mom or dad when they know they're having a bad day. They might have had too much to drink. They're angry, or they just had a fight, mom and dad, and you're kind of tiptoeing. So you're being this sweet little girl and people pleasing to death. And this is when, as an adult woman, then we feel like we're overdoing for everybody, our kids, our partner, at work, and we feel so burnt out and so exhausted trying to please everyone, and nobody's pleased, especially ourselves. So I reteach boundaries and the ability to say no. So people pleasing is very common for women. Of course, many people self-medicate when they're upset, so they're drinking too much or, you know, doing something else to escape those feelings.
So What happens when relationships seem perfect and then they turn toxic?
Okay, so this is where it gets super tricky. All right, so people of childhood trauma have some beautiful qualities about them. They're very loving and affectionate. They want love in the worst way. They really, really want it. They try very hard to have love. Something inside is saying, something's wrong, so I'm going to put my best shot out there and, you know, lure them in with, they're very sexy, they're very sensual. They've learned to do whatever skills they had to do to charm mom and dad or be popular at school where they felt they fed in, but, you know, home life was tough, but school, they were like, you know, kind of popular because they learned what to do to be charming. So these folks come off very charming. They look like the ideal partner. And this is the hardest thing to decipher. So these relationships look perfect. And then around 4 months to 9 months, or if there's an engagement, or if you start living together, or there's a marriage, this is when it tends to really explode. And then the more innocent partner, like, is just trying their best to keep the partner calm, or saying, you know, if I just do this, or if I just change that, because again, they're controlling. Okay, I'll dress a different way now to please him. You know, I want to make sure he's not angry. And then finally, these women come into me and they're like, I don't even know who I am anymore. I lost myself. I have no idea who I am. So this is, you know, all the dynamics that I see on a regular basis and help coach them through in the life portion. Then I give them the exact skills they need while they're out there dating, to ask the certain questions they need to ask to find out if someone's of trauma and how severe is it. Okay, so there's certain questions that I teach they need to ask. And my clients have a lot of one and done dates, but it's a numbers game because they find out on the first date, is this person of trauma? How severe is it? Have they worked on it? Are they more positive or negative mindset? You know, how consciously and spiritually aware are they? This is all things that my people will analyze after I teach them exactly what to do. And that's where I feel that I was missing. Nobody told us.
Now, that's amazing.
Cool, you know? So I wanted those answers. I read over like 250 books and, you know, pulled this program together to get the exact answers that I can help the ladies with, or gentlemen, you know, at the same time.
Well, to do it so quickly before you get involved and start to care about the person and have the hormones flowing, if you do it quickly.
Well, chemistry is very dangerous. Let me warn your listeners. Chemistry is taking you back into your past because your unconscious, your subconscious is attracted to your normal. What you're used to, it feels comfortable, even though it's dysfunctional. So falling in love by chemistry is extremely dangerous. So that's why you have to have the questions. That's why you have to be consciously aware. That's why we have to know what your childhood traumas are and what you're looking for and why you might be drawing these types of folks to you. And then, you know, then you're going to know really easy who is unhealthy and who's healthy.
But I'm also saying that it's very important, as you're saying, to do it quickly.
Yes.
Right at the beginning before you let yourself get.
Correct. My clients will know within 1 or 2 dates if they're a yes, you keep moving forward, or a no, and they know exactly why. Then they keep going until they find that emotionally healthy person.
And so the next question is, what happens if someone doesn't heal their own trauma and they don't recognize these traits?
The pattern keeps going on and on and on, which is really sad. They keep reattracting the same type of people. And in the beginning, it's great. So like I said, the innocent party hangs in there and just keeps working with it. And sometimes it gets good. Like, you know, if there's a Dr. Jekyll, when he's great, he's wonderful. But when he's bad, he's horrid. Like, it's so hard to deal with. But you keep hanging in there for the good times and keep hoping for them to improve and get better. And I'm certainly at fault of this. You know, we fall in love with someone's potential, you know, and being a coach and a counselor, you know, we feel, well, we can help them through whatever they're dealing with. So I've been more patient because it's just in my makeup. I'm a very spiritual woman and forgiving. So that's more in my makeup. And I've had to learn to say, no, you know, a nice person, but not for me. Good luck in your search or whatever. You know, you learn what to say and to get move on quickly. Yeah.
So now we switch to the opposite. What does an emotionally healthy, happy relationship really look like?
Okay. I'll give you a few of them that are coming from my book. I mentioned over 20, so I can just give you a few on this podcast. I have this saying, it's you and me against the world. So the couple is always considering each other first in their decisions, actions, words, and deeds. Always. You know, is this good for me, the woman? Is it good for my partner? Is it good for my children and extended family? Or is this decision, words, or deeds good for me in the community or on the job? Obviously, the man I was married to didn't do the four questions and ruined his entire life, right? Got fired from his job, lost me, lost his income. You know, it was a mess. Humiliated in his community. So, you know, you got to ask yourself the four questions because the impulsive type is the ones that is most sabotaging. So you could be very responsible, but if your partner is impulsive and sabotaging, they could bring you both down. Very dangerous. And then I talk about balance triangles. And this is number two, you, me, and us. So an equilateral triangle where you give enough time to yourself, enough time to your partner, and enough time for you two as a couple. And you want to always keep in mind the balances, and there's many balance triangles I discuss, but anxiety is telling you, it's a signal that something is off. So if balance in life is off, and you know, between you two as a couple, or you within yourself, which is mind, body, spirit, you know, you have to monitor those three areas within yourself. That's where anxiety comes from. So, you know, depression and anxiety is telling you something. You don't want to just pop a pill and make it go away. We learn to be in tune with our bodies and know what it wants and then fix it holistically. That's part of the teaching. Okay, a third one, be what you want to attract. So for you single ladies, if you want a man, a partner who is financially secure, be financially secure, right? If you want somebody that has a high credit score, have a high credit score. So the first thing in life coaching that we teach is we look at all the life areas and we make sure you're that successful single first, because you want to feel amazing about yourself, where you are in life, your life purpose, friendships. We look at everything, your health, mind, body, spirit, everything. Make you feel fantastic about yourself. Then it's so easy to attract someone into your life. It's like this. People laugh at me. I mean, I meet people in parking lots. I meet people at restaurants. I just walk in. I just say hello, you know, and it's so easy to meet people. So I teach you a lot of my techniques, but you got to feel fantastic about yourself. Your own aura of energy says a lot.
People feel it.
They do.
You know, you think that you can hide.
Yeah.
I once had someone say that I offered her a body therapy session and she was saying, you know, oh, I wouldn't want to reveal myself so much, but she was revealing herself just by her posture and her clothing and attitude. Yeah.
Totally. People can feel your energy. So another one is getting your top six requirements met. Now, requirements are deal breakers. For example, if there's a young woman that definitely wants marriage and a family, my clients find out on the first date, are you a man or, you know, someone, a woman, because women who partner up adopt kids, are you somebody that wants children in your life? Do you see marriage for yourself? Find out on the first date. If it's a no, or yeah, kids are okay, but I have a couple nieces and nephews, one and done, next. You know, it's that simple. You have the requirements. We go through the requirements together, get them really solid in your mind. And if anyone is not missing, you know, matching those requirements, here's another one. Requirements can be something that's a little silly. Like, I love to dance. I was a disco dance queen and a champion in Pennsylvania. So I seriously love to dance. If my partner on the first date says, nah, I don't really like to dance, like I have to get drunk to dance, it's like, next. No way. That's a requirement that makes me feel happy. Or I love to travel. Someone must also love to travel. So we have to get the requirements down. The most important one, someone living in integrity, who's honorable, trustworthy, very important, right? Requirements. And then there's the sillier ones, like loves another one, like my client from the TV show, absolutely must love dogs. If his partner, if Scott's partner did not want dogs in his life, he was not going to date that guy. No way. Okay. So we have to figure out what your requirements are. Then we go from there. And then there's emotional and functional needs, and we have to define those as well. So there's a lot that we go through, and the workbook is the guide ship. You know, that is the mainstay of the program for those that work with me one-on-one for 6 months, or those that will go in the 90-day program at the school. There's worksheets and the workbooks, and this is all the stuff based on, you know, the research I've done. So it's a step-by-step, one worksheet leads to the other. And you're just growing and learning in so much time. And the good thing about that, Erica, the skills they learn, they'll have forever. So once they get beyond that traumatic response and the unconscious emotional triggers become conscious and they're now consciously aware what they're doing, they have these skills forever. And so,
yeah, so what you're creating, it's a little work early on, but it's like anything. If you build a business, it's hard work at the beginning, and then it builds. And that's the way relationships are. So if you understand them and you go in strong, wow.
But, you know, people don't see it as hard work when they're with me. They just love it because they're learning so much information they never got anywhere else. And I was like me, soaking up all these books and underlining. It's like, oh my God, I have to remember this. And then it's all cut into my programs, you know, all the research that I found. And it's just so helpful. So people are really excited as they go through, because like they just feel themselves changing with each lesson. They just become more evolved, more spiritual, more confident, more grounded, less anxious and fearful about themselves and about life. So it's a beautiful transformation that I have the honor and privilege to be a part of with those that I work with.
Wow. Yeah. Beautiful. So tell us about your free gift and what you have. Tell about the school.
Okay. Yes, it's the lifeandlovetrainingacademy.com. You can write me support at the life, not the, Life and Love Training Academy. No the in there. And also, if you would like a free life and love transformation strategy session with me, just go to my website. It's rianamilne.com, RIANAMILNE.com. And there's a pop-up form. Just fill that out. I'll be glad to meet with you on Skype. And I give you an hour of my time. It's a $500 value. We look at what the childhood traumas might have been that you have experienced and how they're coming out in your adult life and how I can help you best. And the school is now taking enrollment, so you can just write me either at RianaMilne@gmail.com and say, give me information about the school. There are webinars coming up, both for singles and couples. So to get on my mailing list, to be a part of that webinar where I go really deep into this information, just sign up. I give free chapters of my book, too, at RianaMilne.com. That'll put you on my mailing list. Email me, Rianna, I want in on the webinar. I'll make sure you get on my mailing list. Because my mission is trying to get this information out to as many people as I can and help as many people as I can. So the school, the 90-day program, is more affordable than those that want to work with me one-on-one, which is 6 months. But that's, you know, I can go really deep, and then they're on my clock. They can text me. They can call me, you know, with a VIP program. Or there's the school program where they go through as groups. But either way, I'm their coach. I'm the one that's helping them. So ladies, please reach out to me however I can help you. I would love to. And keep in mind, like, you know, even the best of love relationships will have issues, but you'll need to learn those communication skills so you're not triggered and fighting through them. And if you can learn them, you can help teach your partner. But I would suggest if you're a partner who is struggling, or a couple, get into the online school for couples. It's called Relationship Rescue, where I can train you together. And the cool thing about the couples one, I train the man separately and the woman separately, and then they're in the group together. So they're both learning separately with their own worksheets, but then they're in the group class and practicing these skills with their partners as they go along. So it's really created quite differently to make sure there's success.
Yeah, and you're certainly bringing in information that they're not getting anywhere else. It's not just communication.
Right.
It's much more. It's knowing yourself and knowing what the other person went through and how they might be thinking. It sounds amazing.
And your
free gift of an hour, I mean, I think that alone could help to change someone's life.
I try because it's really important to have the knowledge. You can't change what you don't understand. That's my quote. So I help them try to understand what's going on with the very first contact with me through Skype. And then we go from there. What is it they'd like to do? Which program seems like to be the best fit? And, what are they struggling with? And I give them several tips, right on the phone call or in the Skype call. Yeah.
So if you had a last tip, what would you say to women?
It's time to have the life and love you deserve, ladies. Come on. If not now, when? I do always say the clock is ticking, no matter what age we are. And I will be celebrating 60 this month. I'm very excited about that.
Well, happy birthday almost.
Thank you. Because age is a state of mind and energy. And, when you feel very good about your life and who you are and what you're doing, your purpose work, everything comes together. So if you're struggling, I'm here for you. Reach out to me, RihannaMilne.com. I'd love to hear from you, ladies.
Rihanna, thank you so much for sharing on this summit.
Thank you, Erica. Thank you. And be safe out there with this hurricane coming.
And to those of you listening, I look forward to speaking to you again soon.
Thank you.